the beginning of a whole new era of biological understanding, and one where I think MIT is really extremely well positioned to lead.
The planet is changing and new diseases are coming. The things that we thought we were treating are changing in real time, which as inventors is an opportunity, but it's really a call to action.
Things that might have taken years in the past can be done in weeks, if not days, using the power of computation. And what better place to invest in technology than MIT?
At MIT, it's not simply the discovery that's up at the top of our ambition list. It's also applications of those discoveries to making the world better, to coming up with better products, better ways to do things.
One of the things that we're excited always to collaborate with our colleagues at MIT around is, how do we make big leaps? How do we make daring departures from what is obvious and adjacent? And that's where many of the breakthroughs come from.
We want to find a mechanism to bring people from lots of different areas together so we can get this synergistic effect to solve really important problems.
There's been a natural confluence of the science, the medicine, the capital, and the entrepreneurs. And that doesn't exist anywhere else in the world. And MIT has been focal to that.
Being in this environment allows us then to tie into that ecosystem and to learn from them in terms of understanding how best the work we do can be applied outside. But vice versa, it allows them to have access to how we're thinking about pushing the boundaries of the future. And so that's one of the many reasons that we are launching MIT Heels.
Anyone who has spent any time at MIT knows this place has a secret sauce. And I love so much that we can now combine that with the strength at the hospitals, with all of the remarkable industry connections in Kendall Square, to really move health and life sciences forward in ways that we can only imagine.
All right, good morning again. So I'm Sally Kornbluth, president of MIT. And I'm delighted to welcome you to the launch of the MIT Health and Life Sciences Collaborative, or simply MIT Heels. I'll have more to say about MIT Heels in a moment, but first, it's my honor to introduce a very special guest this morning. Since she was elected to the Commonwealth of Massachusetts just 2 years ago, Governor Maura Healey has focused on making the state a leader in clean energy, a more affordable place to live, and a great place for businesses of all kinds to start, grow, and succeed. Here at MIT, we especially appreciate her personal enthusiasm and advocacy for the state's interlocking innovation ecosystems, from climate technology and advanced manufacturing to AI and the life sciences. So we could not be more delighted to have her with us today as we launch MIT Heels. Please join me in offering a warm welcome to Massachusetts Governor Maura Healey.
Well, good morning, and thank you so much, President Kornbluth. Belated happy birthday to you. Look, I got word that this was happening, and I never want to miss an opportunity to visit MIT. And I mean that. So to all of you who are here, Madam President, distinguished faculty, scientists, and leaders from across this great university, thank you for all that you do, and thank you for all that you're going to do, because today is about what you're going to do, and it's so, so exciting. Congratulations on this launch of MIT Heels. I love that title and what it encapsulates. I was also delighted to be to have a moment with your co-chairs of this morning's symposium, Dr. Amy Keating and Katarina Rybak. Lovely to meet you both, although Amy and I go way back because we went to that other school down the way. You know, one of the things as governor that I really appreciate is the opportunity to see so many of our state's accomplished scientists and brightest minds come together, work together, and forge a new commitment to improving human life. It's even more exciting when you think about this convening to think about all the amazing cures and treatments and discoveries that will result from it. And I'm proud to say, and I really believe this, this is something that can only happen in Massachusetts. There's no place that has the ecosystem that we have here. We must fight hard to always protect that and to nurture that. But we have the greatest scientists in the world, the greatest universities, the greatest hospitals. We're number one for innovation, for education, and for healthcare. And we draw top talent from all over the globe. We believe in solving hard problems. We, in fact, embrace solving hard problems. And this university has always been about thinking of ways to reduce suffering, help humanity, and further the common good. We also are home to, and I find this remarkable, you know, four of the 12 Nobel Prize winners this year, four are from Massachusetts, and of course, two are from this great university, and it's just another indication of Massachusetts and this ecosystem always punching above its weight, so to speak. This is what gives us and distinguishes us among global competition, both for talent and for innovation and for output. It's why I also worked hard to go out and recruit and appoint Yvonne Howe as a leader in an innovation economy to come and lead economic development for the state. I appointed Kate Walsh to be our Secretary of Health and Human Services, a leader of one of our world-class teaching hospitals. It's why we worked hard, many in this room, to go out and get after and win the Investor Catalyst Hub in ARPA-H, which is the federal government's new medical discovery agency. And it's why in our new economic development law that I recently signed, we are making a transformative commitment as a state to the Mass Life Sciences Initiative. This has made us a global leader, and our charge is to lengthen that lead. And it's one of the reasons I'm here to say thank you, because what you are doing in furthering aligns with our state's interests and where we want to go. That includes also investments in making Massachusetts the global hub for climate technology and for applied AI and all sorts of things that you are already ahead of us on, but we are looking forward to sync up and support what you are doing. And it's not by accident. This is who we are in Massachusetts. We don't just believe in science, we lead in science, and we also know that that requires intentionality and effort every single day. And that's what you do in your classrooms, in your labs, and other spaces. And when I say we, make no mistake about it, I mean you, the scientists, the brains, the researchers, the students of the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. And as President Kornbluth knows, MIT and the state of Massachusetts, the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, have a long and very connected history. So thank you for all that you do. I think that the MIT Heals initiative really reflects our strengths of our state in some really profound and important ways, and in ways that we know are particularly critical at this moment, as we once again affirm collectively our commitment and indeed reverence for science, for knowledge, for innovation, for collaboration, and for partnerships that will really help us transcend in time. In this moment in our nation's history, in our world's history, your leadership and the work that you do is more important than ever. I cannot wait to see the results of it. I look forward with my team to getting out to various things you have happening related to this wonderful, wonderful effort. And I just thank you for being here in Massachusetts and making not only our state better, but our country and indeed our world better. So enjoy the rest of this wonderful, wonderful day. And thank you, President Kornbluth.